enhances the education of our children by helping them to make connections and broadening the depth with which they feel and think. If we are to hope of a society of culturally literate people, music must be a vital part of our children's education. Namaste and good evening. On behalf of the Associated Board of the Royal Schools of Music, I heartily welcome the performers, teachers, and parents, as also our special guests, Mr. Hisayoshi Matsui, Mrs. Selina Krishnan, Mr. Jagdish, and Mr. Rehan Siddiqui. Today, we are here to celebrate the success of the high achievers and to recognize the contribution of our teachers for spreading quality music education through the ABRSM curriculum. ABRSM's mission is to inspire achievement in music. We do this by supporting music making, teaching and learning in partnership with our four Royal Schools of Music in the United Kingdom: the Royal Academy of Music, the Royal College of Music, the Royal Northern College of Music and Drama, and the Royal Conservator of Scotland. In the past years, we have seen a rise with musicians of all ages appearing for the ABRSM exams, and India becoming a strong leader in the field of Western classical music education. Dear performers, we congratulate each one of you for the commendable hard work you have put in by juggling between your academic demands and being able to beautifully manage your time to pursue your passion for learning music. This music education will take you a long way, as music is being used in the field of engineering and medicine, along with various scientific research. Currently, universities all over the world and corporates recognize the value of quality music education and give weightage to an ABRSM certification, which will give while giving admission or while hiring, due to the gold standards we maintain. Before I end, I would like to thank all our partners and supporters of our exam centers, the management of the Bangalore School of Music and Fine Arts, St. Mark's Music Academy, Urban Raga Music Institute, and Harmony, the music school, for all the cooperation and support. Especially our ABRSM representatives from Bengaluru, Mrs. Usha Urs, and from the Indus International School, Mr. Joseph McKenna. Dear teachers and parents, you are the prime stakeholders in the forum and the backbone for our musical revolution. We are grateful and thank you that you chose the world-renowned, the ABRSM Examination Board. And above all, thank you to our dynamic performers. Continue to broaden and enhance your music skills. Thank you, dear guests, for being such a wonderful audience and being a part of this celebration. Wishing you all a lovely evening. We now request our chief guest, Mr. Hisayoshi Matsui, General Manager, Yamaha Music India, to please come and say a few words, please, sir.
My name is Hisayoshi Matsui. I'm working in Yamaha Music India as a general manager for sales and marketing division. First of all, it is our honor to be here today for the ABRSM High School Concert, and big, big congratulations to all the people who will be performing tonight. We are very happy to see that with the effort from the ABRSM, many people are now learning and enjoying Western classical music. The collaboration with ABRSM has started from last year, and we share the same vision, popularizing high-quality music education in India. And today is the first time we joined this wonderful event in Bengaluru. Passing the exam is one big, big achievement, but also we also feel that the presenting the talent in front of the audience is one another enjoyment of playing musical instrument. So having this kind of opportunity like today should be very helpful for all. How many people know Yamaha? Oh, thank you very much. As you have seen in the earlier corporate video, Yamaha Corporation was established in 1887, and one person named Mr. Yamaha had started by repairing the school lead organ. So after that, almost 130 years have passed, and we have tried to bring the best products to all the musical players in the world. And one point that I would like to emphasize is not only making the best musical product, but we also care about how it is used by our customers. So 1954, we in Japan, we have already started this music school because we thought that this musical instrument can help the children to get musical education. So we have started the Yamaha Music School during that time. So both we are making the product and we are trying to bring the service also so that together children can focus on music education. And Yamaha Music India has started direct sales distribution in India in 2008. So this 2018 is a good anniversary, 10th year anniversary for our company. And again, we are really seriously focusing on this India. And our commitment and investment is increasing day by day. One good information that I would like to share today is last year we announced that we will come up with the Yamaha India factory in the state of Tamil Nadu. So 2019, we are hoping to launch the factory and bring the best reasonable product which matches the requirement of the Indian customers. Currently, we are planning to launch keyboard and guitar. So I hope this everybody can also utilize for the support of their music education. So again, together with the ABRSM, we will continue to work hard to support the music education in India. Thank you very much.
We now request Mrs. Selina Krishnan, Director, Academics and Principal, India International School, Bengaluru, to please come and say a few words, ma'am.
It is indeed a pleasure to be surrounded by music lovers. I'm sure most of you are either musicians, you support music, or you have parents or children who play an instrument. Good evening. When I heard Joseph McCann's name mentioned, I said, I must say that I was a part of the school where he still continues working, and that is the Indus International School. I retired there as vice principal last year. And together, we started an orchestra. And when I left Indus, we had 220 students who could play the toughest pieces on many instruments. And this continues to be what Indus is known for. And we had about 90 odd students in the choir. We had a 4-member team of teachers, and I would be monitoring that closely, giving them the tough pieces to play. And all this came from my own know-how of music, because I grew up in a family of musicians. And my mother, till about 2 weeks before she had her stroke, when she was 83 last year, she had about 20 students coming home to play music. She is on the road to recovery, though she can't use her right hand, but she still moves in a wheelchair to one of the pianos in the house, and she plays with her left hand. So I feel that music has its therapeutic value. And if you look back in history, we can see how music has changed the world. Songs have changed the world. Songs like Imagine, which we sing so often. Then there are so many other songs like Blowing in the Wind. So these songs have revolutionized certain aspects of our history where they have fought for rights. So music does value. And also, music definitely relieves us from stress. Way back in the early 19th century, it was classical jazz. In our growing years, it was a different kind of music. So with every passing generation, there is a style to music. So why is man drawn to music? That is because as human beings, we are rhythmic creatures. There is rhythm in our heartbeat. There is rhythm in every cycle of life, everything that we do, whether it's our breathing rates, our hormone cycles, our sleep cycles. Well, all this is affected by music. And music is a discipline that requires hours and hours of practice. It's the 10,000 hour rule. So if you want to be a good musician, you just have to devote yourself to music. I have two grandchildren who are learning to play the piano. One is 7 and one is 9. And it's so difficult to keep them for that 1 hour every day to learn, to make them practice their scales, because they just tell me, "Party, it is so boring." And they just want to take off playing whatever they want without, you know, using the skill that is required, the sight reading. So it takes a lot of bribery every evening by the time we can get them to practice. So all my young musicians over here, don't give up. You have no idea what makes you so special. Music creates a whole person. It gives you that personality. So continue, do your exams, because everything needs to be recorded in life. And believe me, when you apply for those universities, when you come to grade 12, even with your low scores, high-ranking universities will still take you, because they see in you a certain discipline which not everybody has. Because it has taken you that discipline to reach that level of music. And it is believed that if you can play one instrument, you may be able to play another one itself. The pattern of music is the key to all learning. So when you learn music, it improves your mathematics skills, your chemistry, and your physics. Believe me, you will be top students. So also music provokes very, very intense emotions. And according to Plato, music is a moral law. It gives soul to the universe, wings to the mind, flight to the imagination, and charm and gaiety to life. Look at songs like Times, they are a-changing. They are a-changing. But you stick on to playing your classical pieces, and believe me, music is life. That is why our hearts have beats. All the best in whatever instrument you wish to play. Thank you.
Our other chief guests have also arrived, and we would like to welcome Dr. Nanita Rubin, Vice Principal, Bishop Cotton's Boys School, Bengaluru. Mr. and Mrs. McCloskey, Deputy Head of School and Primary Principal, Stonehill International School, Bengaluru.